Fashion Catwalk is brought to you by
NCB Keycard. I feel everybody, everybody. I feel everybody.
This is Mission Catwalk Season 6, the Celebrity Edition. 12 designers will join 3 celebrity teams to compete week after week for a chance at a designer-celebrity collaboration. Over $2 million in cash and prizes to be won. Who will complete this mission? Who will rule the catwalk?
It's gonna be a party, y'all. Everything is alright. Step all clean from my head to my feet. Me ready now fi turn up the
street. Who created this mess?
Me and couple of friends pull up on the end.
Hello, designers.
Hello.
For your next mission, you will create an avant-garde design using recycled material to highlight the current environmental issues we face with garbage pollution. You will have access to this pile of rubble to create wearable art. You will have a budget of $2,000 to purchase additional fabric at Pablo's to support your design. You will have 10 hours to complete this mission, and then it's catwalk time. Good luck.
I mean, they said, okay, so they had the pile of garbage in the front or whatever. When it was time to like get everything, they literally dived into the trash, and I'm just like, let me get my bag and go.
I bought a very cheap fabric. I used 2 cheap fabrics, so the first challenge for me was trying to make something where like, the fabric wouldn't look as cheap as it actually is, and then trying to use the styrofoam to make it look even cleaner and more just nice, you know?
My dress is a storm dress. I did an avant-garde before. Even though I never win, I come second.
Everybody will know me now, say, I love art, so. Yeah, I think I have that one here. Yeah.
I'm creating a dress from garbage bags. I'm doing some pleat with the garbage bags. Dramatic look at the bottom. Pleat at the top, sweetheart dress.
I decided to use the styrofoam as well as garbage bags, and then I guess fabric. I think I tried to incorporate newspaper. I think I still will, but I'm just not 100% sure yet.
I love doing avant-garde because I like to think outside of the box and just do big, bold stuff.
What? What? What's up? I saw some of your sketches, right? So Steven, what was like your inspiration behind that sketch?
So I'm doing like a cape blazer and a newspaper pan. So I'm using cups, styrofoam cups, garbage bags, and newspapers.
Oh, wow.
So I kind of did like a structured coat and a tailored pants out of newspaper as well. And I created these kind of cone shapes to kind of represent the spiraling effects, downward and upward spiraling effects of pollution.
Rochelle, so I saw your silhouette.
Yeah.
What's happening? So we're doing the top half and the bottom half.
Right.
Okay.
So my fabric is nude. It's a mixture of 2 different tones of nudes, and I'm going to be using styrofoam to create the little triangular and diamond shapes to create the pattern on the fabric.
Okay. All right. So Shoshana, you know, tight-fit dress. What's happening?
I'm gonna do like a fitted dress and then a raised area on the shoulder. So I'm not using any fabric whatsoever. And I'm doing a headpiece to make it like even more dramatic.
Miss Melissa, what's happening? What was that for y'all? You look stressed out, girl.
No, I'm not stressed.
Mm-hmm.
So okay. I'm thinking about a fitted dress with like flashy pleats around it, and the top would have like a crooked effect.
We don't want to get eliminated from the runway. I remember saying, we never come up with not 1 up, but 2 up. So can I get an up, up?
Up, up.
The inspiration behind my design is domino effect. It's like a matrix with squares, small squares and bigger squares placed together. It looks like dominoes.
What's up, guys?
We're good, how are you?
I'm good. I mean, I got some of your designs. I'm pleased with most of them. But Mr. Daniel.
There.
What are you sending me, though? I'm not seeing no aesthetic, me not seeing no drama, me not seeing no attitude. You just send me one stick woman, one stick man. Don't do it.
Me not good at the drawing, but when it comes to designing, me good at that.
My idea behind it was a frame I see, and like what take place, and I see a little buckle on the surface. It fish them there below, so that means a battle affect a wildlife in I see.
So I'm wondering if you're not really good at the drawing, but when you put it on somebody, it works.
Yeah.
All right, I mean, good going, guys. I'm really impressed. Just Daniel with that beat. But since you've experienced,
my initial sketch. It had some sculptural things at the top, which I was going to do with styrofoam to represent the waves at the ocean. The bottom would have been sculptural as well, but as I started to work, I wanted to add movement. So I changed it around and I said, all right, I'm going to do a very exaggerated fringe skirt. So I used the garbage bags, to create the fringe. And the effect is really dramatic. It's really beautiful. I think it's going to look great on the model.
So how are you guys feeling though?
Get real now. People go home soon.
And I swear now, I feel like say people they use it as an opportunity. We say what they want. Like and that style is it. So like them joke and them talk to you. Come realize it, then joke. Then say this, then say that. But really, how they really feel, but they just wanna say it in a way where you know offend you and you're not gonna really pick up to it.
I think it's just intense because we have a lot of work to get done and we want to get finished and running out of time.
All right, can I start with you, Anna? That's a long sleeve?
Yeah.
Oh, I love that, that's nice. Okay. What are those designs on? That's the back part of the outfit, right?
Yeah, I'm thinking of doing...
And there's a V in the back?
Yeah.
I like it.
Okay.
I'd actually wear that outfit.
Yeah.
So the one colored that is your jacket that you have on today?
Yes.
I love your outfit. Okay. I love it. Is there a split on this dress?
No, there isn't. It's going to be a gore, so it's going to have a kick down at the tail. Similar to a fishtail, but without the fishtail kind of, you know. And there's going to be a...
What do you use to make that? Newspaper?
No, for the skirt part, I'm going to use fabric. I don't think the newspaper will fall as well, but I'm going to do a draped peplum out of newspaper for that peplum area.
And it's gonna be a what?
A draped peplum. It'll be exquisite. I don't think I'm doing the best that I can do.
I think speed is very important, efficiency. And I'm happy I identified that now. So I'll improve.
Will complete this mission. Who will rule the catwalk? This segment was brought to you by Pablo's, the official fabric store for Mission Catwalk.
I don't have any cash.
No problem.
What's this?
This is your never miss a sale anywhere, anytime, very secure, accepts debit and credit cards device.
So we can use it?
Yup.
I can carry it anyway.
That's right.
So it only does this?
No.
You can also do this.
Is it safe?
The best EMV chip technology.
Nice.
Honey, how about this one?
So we can accept US and key card now?
Absolutely.
Can I see how much money the drivers collect?
Yup. Look at your tablet.
So I can see real-time transactions?
Yup. Even out there. In short, it's your NCB mobile card machine. Never miss a sale anywhere, anytime. Get yours today.
will complete this mission, who will rule the catwalk?
I'm kind of stressed out because I feel like I'm not moving fast enough, but hopefully I'll get it done in time.
No, it's a competition and you have to bring your A game, so everybody's focused.
You just show you how you really work on your seat. So you see now, I go focus on myself and everybody else focus on yourself.
I think I am my biggest competitor right now because I am always in kind of like in my head. So I really feel like if I keep staying in my head, it could be a good thing. Because I tend to overanalyze things, but I think that works in my advantage because it always keeps me aware and makes me have like a editing eye when I design.
Hey, Rochelle.
Hi.
What are you working on today?
Okay, so I'm working on a two-piece gown. I just finished my base, so I'm now gonna add the applique. I chose styrofoam as.
Why did you choose styrofoam?
I just felt like with the fabric that I had chosen, mm-hmm. the contrast would be nice.
Honestly, what are you going to use to fill up the space? Because I don't know what else would work
well, I have well different, with this styrofoam. The appliques that I cut out, I have three different sizes.
Okay.
So I'm going to have different sizes, right?
And then the finishing has to be perfect. I see loose threads hanging off. And, you know, we need that to fit well. So beyond that, I think it's stunning.
Thank you.
So I am making a little black dress. I'll be pleating the garbage bag all over the dress. And I'm just going to make a simple and piece from plastic bottles.
And is that to give it an avant-garde look?
Yeah.
I think it's too simple. I need a bit of drama. I need a bit of zest.
Initially, I was going to make it long at the bottom. And then I decided that I was going to go with a shorter dress. But then he encouraged me to go back to my original design. So I'm going with that.
So you had all this sitting down and hiding. You have extra fabric. Use it. Okay. I think this looks 10 times better already. And it has an impact and it's visually stunning. Hey Daniel, what are you working on?
I'm actually working on the trail for my garment. This is going to be the back. At first I was going to make a kimono coming over with this, but I got a better idea to do something that no one had ever seen before, so.
I don't think anyone's ever seen this before. You have to explain this to me, I'm lost.
The idea behind this is to use as much plastic bottles as I could, as much recycled material as I could, more than using regular fabric. Yes, so I wanted to design this first, and then after that, this is going to inspire me to design the actual garment.
This is going to inspire you to design the undergarment?
Yes. Tricky, right?
Very tricky, and you're moving in a very organic fashion. I'm really concerned because you don't even have a form with the base to see how this is going to look. Do you think this is pretty?
It's not pretty, but it's not something you see every day.
Yeah, but you need to make a garment that's wearable. Every woman, they want to look beautiful. That's always the goal. And if you as a designer can't make a woman beautiful, they won't buy the product. This really worries me. You have styrofoam fish on plastic with, you know, just cotton on the ends. I would really start over. My opinion, but I don't want to change your design at all.
In my mentor, so if him say that, he better him say that more than me go to the judges with women have and play stupid and listen to him say and go to the judges and probably get eliminated. So he better me take him advice and learn and feel up as it. But I just say go as it, just deal with it. Rest of me challenge them, I go execute them.
I actually loved his design. I think it was a creative take. Like he said, he found inspiration in a literal sense. And I like that he was trying to create basically like a dirty river with like dead fish and stuff. I thought it was a good thought process for him to kind of take it that literal, in my opinion.
There's so many things you can do with this. I mean, this is very elementary. You want to sketch something? See, I can't even design for you because that would be cheating. You just have to make something else. show us your strengths. You're not showing us your strengths right now. I think you're overthinking this challenge. And the material. This is all garbage, but you can turn all this garbage into really beautiful stuff.
Yes. Everybody see me, Eric, especially you and my claim, say them are my friend, and then I say nothing. And then when Matteo come and I talk, everybody I laugh and I giggy as he eat. So that may have to say about that, but that good still, because I could have rest.
I never done it, made a laugh of it still, just what the mentor said.
Some of them just stubborn. That's a them problem. Then stubborn, but because if all over there we're good in a sense, so we can come in for something and you take the criticism and you fix what you fix, or you just leave it alone. Like some of them have some real attitude. So when the mentor, I gotta tell them the same thing where we are tell them, like, what we can do but laugh.
Hey Sashana, tell me about this very interesting look.
What I'm doing here, I'm laying some shell shapes with the styrofoam. So I'm for right here, I'm gonna do petals. Let me show you the headpiece first. So for this, it will be on this.
You made a fascinator.
Right.
Okay. So why do you need this?
I just
want, if you have this embellishment already in the hair.
I wanted it to work in so it looks like one thing when she has it on.
I think it's quite an ambitious look, but I don't know if I love this. Because if you look on the sketch, it's naturally a stunning garment. It looks like John Galliano from 2003. All this construction and this almost hard armor, and you're adding the styrofoam applique. If you can finish this, it would look really great, but this I would edit.
He didn't like something that I added, but I love it. I get why I say that's his style, but I'm gonna do it all the same. Like, if anything should happen, more I blame myself for drop out. Like, yeah.
What can you make fast? What are you good at? I think you're nervous right now. I think you're honestly under pressure. Calm down.
Alright.
I'm gonna help you solve this.
Who will complete this mission? Who will rule the catwalk? This segment was brought to you by the University of Technology, Jamaica.
To all females, if you're being abused, call a Woman Incorporated's counseling hotline so we can help you find a way out.
Let's save our women, Jamaica.
Oranges, nature's gift to us. Sunshine, dewdrops, and fresh air give us the sweet succulence of pure orange juice. We just bottle it. Pure Country Orange Juice. Taste the pure country difference.
See what Buzz Magazine is all about. Health, fitness, fashion, and beauty. We've got the scoop on sex and relationships, sports, music, and entertainment. See yourself or spot the who's who on Buzz photo pages. Buzz, the Caribbean lifestyle magazine with a difference, keeping you in the know while you're on the go. Your personality is your music, your entertainment, your lifestyle, your magazine. Buzz Caribbean Lifestyle Magazine. Get your copy now. Available at bookstores, pharmacies, and supermarkets island-wide.
Who will complete this mission? Who will rule the catwalk?
So I'm designing for Perry, as you know.
Okay.
So I decided for this challenge to do a male look. He's attending a fashion event. So he's actually walking in a runway show for a non-profit environmental organization.
You have really thought about this, haven't you?
I did. I mean, I wanted to reflect something, you know, that I feel strong about as well. First of all, I did like a kind of cocoon shape coat.
All right.
And I did a pant that would go underneath it as well.
Seems like you're almost done.
I just have some tacking to do, like to add. I'm adding these cones onto the coat, and the cones actually represent like the upward and downward spiral of like the issues that we face with waste disposal and whatnot.
But you have gone so far already in this challenge. I would challenge myself to do another look and then do the cones on the dress so it would complement this newspaper coat.
Okay, definitely. I'll that's something I can do in the time allotted.
All right. Yeah? I think I have no other words of wisdom.
How everyone was excited for avant-garde challenge. It's not really using like fabric. So I guess a lot of people kind of was happy that that happened because you don't really have to sew like actual fabric. And plus it kind of helps you to expand the imagination.
Never done avant-garde before, but I'm still excited about it. And I wanted to do a gown, something elegant, exquisite, and a little inconspicuous. So since we're recycling, we're using garbage, I really wanted to conceal the fact that
it's garbage.
Newspapers, right.
How much more time do you have left? Because I think this could be really
6:11
interesting.
6:11, 5. About 5 hours.
5 hours. Okay. But if this is pleated nicely.
Right. And it's going to be pleated enough so that you can still see half of the bodice area.
Why do you want the bodice showing? The fabric?
Because it's lovely. And it's the design concept.
But that's not the challenge. You're supposed to use the material. Why would you have all this fabric showing when you have more than enough garbage to turn into something really beautiful?
So do you think I should come over a little bit more and show like a little less or none at all?
No, I think you should utilize the entire plastic. This I would change. It's not pretty. This is not pretty at all. And your sketch looks way better than what I'm visually getting here. If you could transform this top with this bottom, you have a winning gown.
The idea for the peplum that I had sketched, it wasn't manifesting as nicely as it was on paper. Yeah, it did look messy.
Hey, Cassandra.
Hi, sir.
Call me sir. You have to stop. Anyway, tell me about your look.
My look is inspired by domination and squares and rectangles. It's like a domino.
Dalmatian
squares and rectangles.
Interesting.
It's like a matrix effect.
Okay.
Yeah.
I need to be wowed. I don't know if I'm wowed yet. It's almost like I want this jacket to come off and then there's a bigger surprise underneath there. I know you have no more fabric, but just take it to another level.
Sir Mattia, make a suggestion about an undergarment under the jacket, and I'm thinking about it. But it depends on what time I finish my jacket to do a next outfit.
I made this dress representing a tornado. So this is a tornado.
A tornado, okay.
Yes, to sweep
it's
up.
It's quite a tornado.
Yes, because if you look at it, you see the movement.
Right.
So it's basically to sweep up all the rubbish, the pollution and stuff.
Oh, you're taking this really literal. I'm concerned that you're rushing. This could be better. This poof skirt.
I didn't like what the size, you know.
But not only the sizing, you could tell when you fold it, it's literally just like you threw the paper on. Step back, I'll show you something. Come. You're losing the shape here. Cause this dress technically should be this.
At one point, I did a fret honestly, because me, I said, boy, my thing now turn out good and everybody won't look. You know, but at the end of the day, everybody has said to me, say, boy, your thing look good, your thing turn up. So that made me feel good.
Why do you need this?
When storm going, you have a lot of windmills about the place. When you go
so
country,
literal.
So it's spinning on her chest.
I think you might have to edit. I don't know if you need this. I would work more off the recycled material here. Hey, Kiwana, tell me about your look.
I use cardboard as shoulder pads. In here, even though it's not, you know, you can't see it, but it's still.
No, it's definitely giving it structure. Okay, so plastic will be on this kimono sleeve.
Yes.
All right, and then there's a sash here. Are we gonna add plastic on this as well, or only the styrofoam applique?
I love Mateo. I think he's so dope, mainly because it just comes very like genuine. I think he really genuinely wants to like help us.
The foundation is already fantastic, so I just need to see you incorporate and use the garbage, but make it pretty. Pretty always win. It has to be pretty.
I started with a sketch.
And it became something completely different.
From it, because okay. I wanted to use the styrofoam to create pyramids.
All right, and you chose only plastic as your recycle blue.
I'm going to incorporate some styrofoam into the top because I want to get some structure.
Why this? Bustier, why this shape? Because the fringe is so beautiful, it looks almost like real fabric and not plastic. Why this shape?
I just like the shape, honestly.
Really? You think this is a flattering shape?
Okay, now you're making me reconsider.
Because this is pretty. Can you see where I'm going? Fix this. You're not going to lose your salvation on this top. I'm serious. Like, step out of your box. Make it a little bit slutty. I don't think anything is wrong with a bit of sex appeal.
Well, I'm rushing because I have the top of my dress, but the bodice to do. And I'm almost finished with the skirt, so I just want to get it done before I run out of time.
Runway, I'm going to feel too bad. Like, if I pull this off, it's going to be interesting. Like, I feel confident about this. It's going to stand out, yeah.
The runway show tomorrow. Well, I'm a little bit nervous.
I'm nervous.
No.
Who will complete this mission? Who will rule the catwalk? This segment was brought to you by Singer.
Morning, sell me one of those honey bun cinnamon roll, please.
We don't have any more honey bun cinnamon roll.
Honey bun. Honey bun.
Do you have a flair for fashion and styling? Hair, makeup, wardrobe? Become a stylist for the next generation of corporate professionals and celebrities. Sign up for the Youth at Jamaica and Hart College of Beauty Services 2-year Joint Associate of Arts degree in Image Consulting and Fashion Styling. Contact 876-970-5405 or 876-926-4340 or email pcar@utech.edu.jm. Come join Jamaica's creative industry revolution.
Who will complete this mission? Who will rule the catwalk?
And hello, celebrity team leaders.
Hi.
Welcome to the catwalk. And welcome to our viewers across the Caribbean. Our designers were asked to create an avant-garde design using recycled material to highlight the current issues we face with garbage pollution. The judges will score your designs as they go down the catwalk, and one will be named the winner and one will be going home. The judges deciding your fate will be Senior Associate Editor at the Jamaica Observer, Ms. Novia McDonald-White, International Menswear Designer, Carlton Brown, and our guest judge, media personality and youth advocate, Empress Golding. Now let's see your designs. Good luck.
The way she wears that dress. The way she moves in fabric with finesse. I want to be like you. I'd love to walk in your shoes. She is a star with a diamond in her eye. She is the ruler of the catwalk in the sky. Catwalk, mission catwalk. Catwalk, the gate can be cruel, take all my pieces and throw them together. When you release me, I'm light as a feather.
Okay, teams, we're gonna bring your models out for one final look and then bring you back to the catwalk. Sparks.
Well, you know, we're Met Gala already, right? Now listen, people will definitely be reconsidering how to dispose of their garbage because one woman's trash is another woman's treasure. They speak for themselves.
Angel.
I'm loving my team effort and their pieces, avant-garde, high fashion, runway ready, and just a different way to dispose your garbage in a happy, high fashion feeling.
Perry, tell us.
All right, of course you can see, you know, from my design house, two of the designs read excellence, you know, no pun intended. And of course, the other two, you can definitely eat it up off the runway, no pun intended again. All designers are still here, which speaks to, of course, their prowess in the design room. So, please, I'm asking
okay,
you all.
Let me ask you this. There's no... Okay, so you've taken garbage and you've taken plastic and you've made outfits, but there is no sense of dilemma. There is no sense of urgency. There's no sense of, well, the earth needs to be saved. So can you just... Did I miss something?
Who will complete this mission? Who will rule the catwalk?
This segment was brought to you by Phase 3 Productions.
Back to school done, but mega money a run! From now to October 20, cash pad mega pot a run more money pan the gold mega ball! Yes! We can win $1,040 and up with any extra $10 mega ball bet and the silver mega ball come back! So we can win $560 and up! Plus, with the new green mega ball, we can win $460 and up! I still only two white ball in the mega pot, but with all the three mega ball every draw, it's easier to win a mega ball! Go Supreme Ventures now, cause cash pad mega money a run!
Will complete this mission. Who will rule the catwalk?
Okay, let's bring out the designers. When I call your name, please step forward. Sashauna? Stephen? Danielle? Melissa? Colette? And Kiwana? If I did not call your name, your scores have qualified you to continue on this mission. You may leave the catwalk. The six of you represent the strongest and weakest designs we saw this week. One of you will be the winner, and one will be out. Let's bring out your models. Stephen, tell us about your look, please.
I was inspired by the drama that Perry normally brings in his clothing. So he's attending a fundraiser for an environmental function in Jamaica, and I created a recycled newspaper pant and a cape.
I love the cape. I think it's avant-garde and it sends a message. The pants, I'm worried, you know. I don't know how Perry would sit in that, if it would rip. But definitely the cape sends that message about garbage pollution.
Thank you, appreciate that.
There's a sense of an alarm when you look at it, you know, which I didn't really see in a lot of the other designs in terms of salvaging the environment, as it were. So there is that sense of urgency, sense of alarm. I feel it's good that the pants are dropping off so that you really understand that it is urgent and it needs your urgent attention. Good job.
You, I must say, you did a very good job of it. And I love the pants as well.
Thank you.
Stephen, very provocative piece. I felt emotional when he walked out. I saw a young man that I saw downtown the other day taking the garbage out. And it's provocative and it's drama. You did good.
Thank you.
I love it.
Thank you, Stephen. Melissa, tell us about your look, please.
In today's society, we have a lot of pollution, air pollution and ground pollution. So I decided to make a dress that moves in circular motion to basically create the impact of taking away rubbish. So basically it's like a thunder dress.
Melissa, I like the skirt on your look. I feel like I've seen it before, but I like it.
That's what they do in primary school, yes. They make fans out of newspapers. I just felt that you could have, you know, done a bit more.
This just looked like a kindergarten project gone wrong. I'm just seeing where, you know, this would fit in one of those garbage bags, really.
But no, I have to agree with them. I've seen it before, as Kenya said, I think. I've seen it before.
Thank you, Melissa. Colette, tell us about your look, please.
Hello, judges. So I wanted to use black and white, with black being the main color to symbolize how dirty and disgusting and serious pollution is, and how it's taking over what little good and cleanliness is left, which is the white part of the dress. And I wanted to also use this this mess, this darkness, to create something elegant and black tie.
It does look elegant. It doesn't look avant-garde, and that's the challenge, because it is an avant-garde challenge. So I know you put a lot of work into the construction and it does look nice and elegant, but it's not speaking to the challenge enough for me.
Yeah, ditto, and the pearls just literally just killed it. So that's it.
This is just a black dress in plastic.
I believe I did what the best I could. I'm seeing that and this is not an excuse. I did run out of time because I was going to recreate, you know.
Don't worry about all of that, it's sure.
Yeah, that is too much. You have to transcend the boundaries of convention when you're talking about this competition. Do your homework and research. You understand? Because I don't think you took it where you could. We all have it in us to do more. You can do better. I would wear it on Environmental Day to a nice little dinner without the pearls. I would. But this is not what this actual task was, to go beyond, yeah? So all the best next time.
Thank you, Colette. Kiwana, tell us about your look, please.
Hello, judges. I remembered a video that I saw in the Dominican Republic. It was a video of basically the ocean just full of garbage, and it was just waves and waves of garbage. What I did was I got a light fabric with a bit of movement. Plastic in the ocean, after it breaks down or breaks down to a certain point, it just gets smaller and smaller and smaller. It doesn't dissolve. It turns into microplastic. So what I wanted to also do was add that element by starting with the larger polka dots and then getting smaller to have that representation in my look.
Kiwana, I love your interpretation. I can't believe garbage bags and styrofoam could take my breath away. When that model walked down the catwalk, I stopped for a minute and said, wow.
Garbage is garbage is garbage. It's overwhelming, right? And I mean, it speaks to that. You handled it very well. I thought you got a bit carried away, perhaps, with the styrofoam plates. But hey, I mean, it's good. Good work.
I mean, the sleeve, it kind of started look drunken-ish, but hey, you know what I mean? We get it.
I like the fact you went into three different items on that dress. Yeah. I definitely like it. I'm wearing that one on Environmental
that
Day.
Too?
Yes. Yeah. That one and the pin. One year, next year, the year after. I love it.
Thank you, Kiwana. So, Shauna, tell us about your look, please.
I wanted to use the most common material that they usually throw away, which are the styrofoam boxes, the cups, and so forth. So I wanted to provide an artistic solution to that problem. I wanted to encourage people with this piece to actually do something artistic with either the styrofoam. You can also use plastic bottles. I wanted to encourage them, every DIY person too, to get creative with their garbage instead of just throwing it through the window.
What's the understructure for this garment?
Oh, there's no material. There's paper and tape underneath it. So I taped the paper until it was sturdy.
I feel like this does look avant-garde. It does send a message. And it's something I could stand in a gallery to send that message without it even being worn.
It's a good effort. Yeah.
That's it, huh? Mm-hmm. Oh, throw me off. Yeah.
It's a good effort.
Yeah. One of the things I love, though, is the headpiece. And I love that. I mean, I love what you did with that.
I like that you used so many styrofoam pieces from the cups to the paper, because we're talking about that in the news. Environmentalists are talking about it. So I can see how many plates and cups were thrown away. And you went all across the island and picked them up and put them into this piece. I think it's bold. I love the fascinator, whatever it's called, the fascinator. Yeah. Yes, yes, yes. I love it. I like it. Good job.
Thank you, Sashana. Daniel, tell us about your look, please.
My look, the white is the earth, and the black is the blanket of pollution, different types of pollution across the earth. So that was my idea, and it was supposed to be inspired by our celebrity team leader as a avant-garde outfit, but wearable. So I wanted it to be like an outfit that could wear to a costume event, especially like that. And the face piece was actually a plate and a cork.
Daniel, you have such a vibrant team leader, and you do an avant-garde piece for her design house that looks like this.
It's a bit underwhelming, to tell the honest truth, but I like your story. So I guess next time it will be better, right?
Somehow this looked to me as if they knew about the challenge 2 weeks ago, and you knew about it the day of presentation.
Right.
I mean, because honestly, for the team leader that you have, that's so fashionable. I know your team leader not going to wear that. There's no work in it.
I like the mask, especially after a kids' party. You've inspired me. I'm going to get every plastic plate and say, kids, here's the next activity. Let's make a mask. And Daniel inspired that. However, that their dress, it's not saying avant-garde. Is that how you say it?
No, it's not. Yes.
Yeah. It not say that.
Not say that at all.
What did the mentor said pushed away my idea, and I really wanted to do my outfit, but I didn't get the chance to do it
That's a wicked mentor, Daniel.
Listen, sometimes you gotta go against the system, go against the boss, go against the mentor, if you really believe it in your heart.
Daniel, it's a competition. At the end of the day, you have to be prepared to defend the garment that you present. Thank you. When I call your name, please step forward. Your designs were the strongest we saw this week, and one of you will be the winner of this mission.
Who will complete this mission? Who will rule the catwalk?
This segment was brought to you by Garnier Fructis.
L'Oreal Paris presents New Colorish Shine.
Turn on your shine.
Turn on your power. Lacquered color, addictive application. Turn on your attitude. New Colorish Shine from L'Oreal Paris. Turn on your shine.
So put a smile on your face and get in the mood.
Juicy Patty.
Serious Jamaican food. Check out the menu, what a venue in your neighborhood.
Juicy Patty.
Serious Jamaican food. Fried chicken, stewed chicken, in the Juicy Patty kitchen. Run down whatever you wish, aki and saltfish. Breakfast, lunch and dinner. Come chill and get your fill. Come eat with us, so delicious. So put a smile on your face and get in the mood.
Juicy Patty.
Serious Jamaican food.
Juicy Patties.
Grab a copy for news you can use. Jamaica Observer, Everyday Matters.
Who will complete this mission? Who will rule the catwalk?
When I call your name, please step forward. Sashana. Kiwana. And Stephen. Your designs were the strongest we saw this week, and one of you will be the winner of this mission. Kiwana, congratulations. You are the winner of this mission. You may leave the catwalk.
I was honestly nervous. Elimination, I was scared. And then, you know, today is just kind of like carried over into this elimination. So I was really nervous. But when they said my name, it was more like, that's me.
Stephen. Very close call. Excellent job. You may leave the catwalk.
Judges.
Sashana, good job. You may leave the catwalk. Melissa, Danielle, Colette, your designs were the weakest we saw this week, and one of you will be out. Colette, you have potential. You're getting a... Is this a second, third chance to wow us? I think you need to bring it next week. You may leave the catwalk. Melissa, Danielle, one of you will be out. Melissa, the judges felt that they've seen the fan dress over and over and you could have really pushed the envelope. Danielle, this look was underwhelming. Melissa, you may continue on this mission. Please leave the catwalk. Please, I want you to learn to stand your ground next time and defend your piece here. Even if you put a piece of scandal bag on the catwalk, defend it to the end because you put it there. Come here.
It may feel like because of my ignorance, so I can't blame the judges. At the same time, I have a lot of potential, probably more potential and more talent than most of the people in the competition, but I make a mistake. And when I make a mistake, you have a PFR mistake.
On the next episode of Mission Catwalk. For your next mission, you will create a garment for your celebrity team leader to turn heads at a Page 2 red carpet event.
I don't care about Colette. We don't have to be friends.
I'm going to try to see if Colette can get beat up every day.
I'm only here to give advice and be a mentor. I'm just concerned about the tailoring and a turtleneck.
This dress is depressing.
I don't think it really worked.
Just standing there, look like him a wood to wooden foot.
This shouldn't be on a runway.
One of you will be out. Brought to you by
NCB Keycard. I feel everybody, everybody. I feel everybody.
Who will complete this mission? Who will rule the catwalk?